Good morning, students. Hope you all have taken up your previous session that was on framing negatives. Sincerely, and at least by now you have an idea which verb is to be used for a particular tense to make a statement into negative. Today our topic is more or less related to our previous session, that is framing negative. The reason is that we use the same verbs to frame a negative as well as an interrogative. Coming up to the topic, children, this particular topic you have already done in chapter 5. However, that time, or the exercise or the sentences you took up that time, were easy to frame into their interrogative form. Look at the example given here. Suppose your statement was, or as you can see on the screen, it is, I am right. In order to frame the interrogative sentence for this statement, the rule was to bring the verb first and then the subject and then the rest part of the sentence. And the sentence was supposed to be ending in question mark. So the basic rule will remain the same, that is, to bring the subject in the second place and place the verb in the first place. Let's see one more example. You have a pen. What has been done here to make a interrogative sentence for this statement is that the verb have has been brought at the first place and you, the subject, has been brought at the second place, and the rest of the sentence is same. The most important thing was that, rather, it will be when you frame an interrogative is to put a question mark. So, based on this, today we will be taking up framing interrogatives for the three tenses which we have learnt till now. The three simple tenses we have learnt till now. Namely, simple present tense, simple past tense, and simple future tense. So let's get started. Read the first example. Before I begin with the example, children, the basic rule is that as for framing negatives, I have told you, focus on the verb and the subject. Here also, you need to focus on the verb and the subject. You can learn both the rules, subject and verb rule, or you can go with one. But whichever way you follow, you must learn that by heart. Either you look for the verb or you look for the subject. So taking the first example, Meeta sleeps early. Here sleeps is my verb and subject is Meeta, which is singular. So in this case, I know after looking at my verb, that is sleeps, the tense is simple present tense. In such a case, the question is framed by using does. After that, the subject, here it is Meeta, and then the rest of the sentence is same. But be careful, you don't have to use the word sleeps as sleeps in the question. It will be only V1 there, that is without S. So the structure is use does with the singular subject and then the verb in its first form. But remember to end the question with a question mark. See the next example. They sleep early. Focus on the verb. The verb is sleep. This is in the first form. And my subject is plural. That is they. They stands for many people. More than two or even more than that. Two or more than two. So the question in this case for a simple present tense is framed by using do, followed by the verb of the sentence, the subject of the sentence, that is they, and then the rest of the sentence. And remember to end the sentence, your question, with a question mark. So what is the structure? Use do plus your subject, which is plural, of course, V1, and end it with a question mark. The next tense is simple past tense. A simple past tense verb is always in its second form. Either you will find a ed word or you will find a word ending with t, and sometimes it is totally different also. For example, eat, second form is ate, A-T-E. So you have to learn all these verb forms, children, from your chapter 19. Now, to begin with, look at the example again. Meeta slept early. Here, slept is my verb. And in past tense and future tense, children, we need not worry about the subject. The subject actually is our main concern, especially in the simple present tense only. So, coming back to simple past tense, the verb here is slept. So my question will be framed using did. If you remember, even the negative was formed in the past tense using did not. That is why I said those who have learned the rules of framing negatives, for them, learning how to frame an interrogative for these three tenses will not be a problem. So after did will come the subject. And then the rest of the sentence. But keep in mind to end up the question using a question mark. See, I have forgotten here and I'm putting now. So you need to remember whenever you're framing an interrogative or a question, you have to end it by using a question mark. And if you have carefully observed, children, the verb pattern in all the tenses is first form, with did also, with do also, and with does as well. It is V1 to be used. Next is our simple future tense. Now, simple future tense verb is will or shall, and the verb is already, action word is already in its first form. Will go, will come, will tell, will speak, always like this. So you need not worry about the first form here, because already your verb in the statement is in its first form itself. So what you have to do, look for the verb. In this sentence, it is will sleep. I will take out the So the verb will sleep is there. I will bring out will at its first place. Then it will be followed by the subject, that is Meeta. Then the action word which is in its first form, sleep. And then the rest of the words which are needed for making a question. And it will end in a question mark. Look at the next example. Children will sleep early. Here my subject is children. Will sleep is my verb. So how we will change it into a question? We will bring the verb at the first place. What you did in chapter 5, it is similar to that. Then will be the subject, that is children, and further the rest of the sentence as it is. And as I told you, in simple future tense, the verb is already in its first form. So no need to worry about the V1 form of the verb. However, you have to remember this note. That verb is always in its first form with do, does, did, will and shall. So before you put up your phones, back to their places. Please listen to this video and watch the things which have been shown here once again so that whatever has been taught to you gets fixed in your mind. Thank you, children. Along with this, I'll be sharing a PDF that is the table of what we have learned today. Reading that table every now and then, or at least once a day, will make you comfortable remembering all these rules. So kindly read those tables at least once a day, even though you don't have English period or no homework of English related to tenses has been given. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.